Hello students of class 6. So today I am going to start a new topic that is relationship between HCF and LCM. Already we have studied the different methods for finding HCF and LCM. So the next task of yours is to complete the remaining question of chapter checkup. Already some questions I have given you as an home task. Okay, now it's your duty to complete all the questions of chapter checkup. Okay, so next I am going to start the next exercise 4.10. Before that, I am going to discuss the relationship between HCF and LCM. So what we observe by seeing the numbers and their HCF and LCM, we find a relationship between HCF and LCM, like in the table in page number 59 it is given. In number 1, see that in the table number 1, it is given that the two numbers are 6 and 10 and their HCF is given as 2 and LCM is given as 30. So what is the product of HCF and LCM? Yes, it is given as 60. And next is product of the two numbers. Product of the two numbers is you have to multiply the two numbers, that is 6 into 10. So it will be 60. So what we are observing here, we are getting that the product of the HCF and LCM is same as the product of two numbers. Okay, this is the final conclusion we are getting from this table. So similarly, in two number, when you multiply the HCF and LCM, you will get the number 2000, which is equal to the product of the numbers. So your task is to complete this table. All are written, just you have to find the HCF and LCM and product of the two numbers as well as the product of HCF and LCM. Okay, so try to do it. Okay, next is the relationship. If suppose the two numbers are given and HCF is given and LCM is not given, so how to find the LCM? There is one formula. You can apply the formula to find the LCM, or you can say HCF, if three of them are given. There are four things. First is two numbers. Okay, so that means two numbers, that means we represent one number as A and we denote the second number as B, and the third one is HCF and the fourth one is LCM. So total there are four things. Okay, out of four, if three are given and one is not given, then how to find the unknown? So there is some formula for finding that unknown. So I am writing that formula. You have to remember that formula. Okay. So see here. So see, this is the relation. If A and B are two numbers, given numbers, then we can write A into B is equal to HCF into LCM. So here you can find any of the number. Suppose see, if A is not given and all the other things are given, that means B, HCF and LCM are given, we can find the value of A by transferring B to that side. Okay, so like that we can make different formulas. So I am writing all the four formulas. First of all, we will find A, then next we will find B, then HCF, then LCM. So see. So students, see, these are the four formulas. Okay, in first box we can find the value of A if HCF, LCM and the second number B is given. Similarly, this is the second one. If the first number is given, second number is not given and HCF, LCM is given, then we can use this formula. Similarly, if LCM and the two numbers are given, then we can use this formula for finding HCF. Similarly, if LCM is not given and all the other things, that is the numbers and LCF is given, then we can use this formula. So remember this formula. Okay, this is very simple. See, we can find the four formulas from this expression only. See here you can see there are two parts. One is left hand side part, another is right hand side part. So already I told some things to you about this. This is an equation. Okay, this expression is called an equation because this is there is an equal to symbol. You have to study in your next class. Okay, there is a chapter expression, algebraic expression and algebraic equation in your in your next chapters. Okay, so there you have to study that if any number is multiplied with other number, then if you transfer one number to that side, it will get divided. Okay, see here, b is multiplied with a, so when you transfer b to that side, then it will gets divided with what? HCF and LCM. You can say this is one of the division fact also. Like, see, if you write 3 is equal to 6 divided by, suppose you can write like this, see, 2 into 3 is equal to what? 6. So you can write the two division facts as 6 divided by 3 is equal to what? 2. This is the first division fact, and the second division fact will be 6 divided by 2 is equal to 3. So see, from this multiplication, from this expression, we can write two division fact. That is, when we divide 6 by 3, we will get 2. And also when we divide 6 by 2, we will get what? 3. So when there is multiplication in one side, okay, when we transfer 3 to that side, it will get divide by what? 6. Okay, similarly, when we transfer 2 to that side, it will get divide. Because here it is what? Because here it is multiplied in left hand side part. Okay, I hope you understood this expression. For now, okay, just try to remember these things. Okay, this makes your this formula easier. Okay, you don't have to remember this formula. You can directly take out the formula, or you can write the formula, this formula, from this expression only. If you know this expression, you can form these four formulas from this expression only. Okay, so let us do the next exercise, that is last exercise, and your task is to complete this table which is present in page number 59. Okay, so see, in question number 1, HCF is given, product of two numbers are given. First number is 60, you have to find the second number, and also you have to find the LCM. So see here, the product of two numbers is given. So one number is 60, so the second number we can find. How to find? See, again, I already told you that from the expression of multiplication, we can find the division fact. So for finding B, 60 will go to that side and it will get divided. Okay. So 4320 divided by 60, you will get what? 72. So that means the second answer, means the second number is what? 72. And next you have to find the LCM. See, this LCM you can find at first also. Like, I have find the first number, then I have found the LCM. So you can do it at first, and these things you can do secondly also. So see, we know LCM is equal to A into B by HCF. So product of two numbers is already given, 4320. So 4320 divided by HCF. HCF is 12. So we can divide it and we can find the answer of LCM, that is 360. Okay. So next I am going to do is question number 5. See, the rest of the question, that is 2, 3, 4, you can do it by yourself, because now you know the formula, so you can easily do it. So I am doing question number 5 directly. So please do the remaining question. Okay. See, now I am giving you so many questions as a home task, because if you do, then you can understand it in better way and you will get an idea to do it. Okay. I am guiding you. I have cleared your concepts. Okay. I am clearing your doubt. So now it's your duty to do it. Okay. Properly. So see, if there is any doubt, then I will be there, no problem. Okay, but first, if you know the formula, then you can easily apply in the formula. You can use the formula to find the answer. Okay, already we have the formula. I have given you the formula for finding HCF, LCM and the two numbers. So you can easily find it, and 2, 3, 4 questions are direct question. So I am doing question number 5. See, product of HCF and LCM is given as 119. And you have to find the two numbers. So it is given that the two numbers are not 1. Okay, it is not equal to 1. That means A is not equal to 1 and B is also not equal to 1. So how to do this question? How to find the number? See, first of all, you have to find the prime factorization of 119. So why we are finding the prime factorization of 119? So that we can understood that which number we can multiply, so that we will get 119. So there are only two numbers, okay, and that are what? Prime numbers. See, these are prime numbers. So 7 and 17, when we multiply these numbers, we will get what? 119. Okay, so first of all, we have to find the prime factorization. By that way, we can say there are only two numbers, and that those are which? Those are what? Those are prime number, which when multiplied, we will get 119. That means the two numbers, A and B are what? 7 and 17 respectively, whose product of HCF and LCM are 119. Okay, so you can say like this, the two numbers are 7 and 17, because apart from these two numbers, no other number we can multiply to get this number. So using prime factorization only, we can find the numbers which can be multiplied to get this. Okay, so therefore we can say the two numbers are 7 and 17. Okay, so there are different properties of HCF and LCM. So the first property is the here it is given in your book, so I am explaining all the properties. So first property is, if you are given any two numbers and we are finding the HCF of the two numbers, so what happened? There are three numbers now. One is the HCF, second is the number, third is the other number. Okay, so there are three things. What is the relation between these three things? See, HCF means we are finding the highest common factor. So suppose if we take any number, okay, suppose I am taking 24 and 36, I want to find the highest common factor. Okay, so here we can easily find the highest common factor. See here, if you find the highest common factor, you will get 12. So 12 is what? 12 is the HCF of 24 and 36, and you can see 12 is the smallest number. Okay, 12 is the smallest number. If you see, there are many factors of 24, there are many factors of 36, okay, but here 12 is what? 12 is the lowest among 24 and 36. Which one is the lowest? 12 is the lowest number, okay, among which? 12, 24 and 36. So in this particular property, first property, you have to see three things. What are the three things? The two numbers and HCF. That means total three things you have to see, and you can easily observe that the HCF is the smallest one amongst the three given numbers. Okay, so HCF will be the smallest one among the three numbers. This is the first property. Now come to the second property. Second property, in this property about LCM is given. If you want to find the LCM of a given number, then you can be able to see that we are finding the lowest common multiple, but that answer, the LCM will be the greatest among the three. Suppose the example which is given in the book, I am giving you the same example again for finding LCM. After finding LCM, we are having three things. First is the two numbers, and third will be what? LCM. There are three things we are having. So now we will find the relation between the three things. See here, if it is what? 6 and it is 10. Okay, so the LCM of 6 and 10 is what? You will get what? 30. It is given in the book. So see, from these three things, what we understood? We understood that the LCM is greater than the two given numbers. Okay, the name suggests this is the lowest common multiple, but that number, okay, but that number is the highest among the three. Okay, among the three. And see, this part which I am discussing, the first property and the second property, this part again you will get in class 10. Okay, when you go in class 10, you will get again these things. Okay, so in HCF, you have to see that HCF is the smallest one among the three, and in LCM, you can observe that number is greater than it is the greatermost among the three. Okay, so these are the two properties. Next come to the third property. Third property is very simple. HCF of two or more co-prime numbers is equal to 1. Because you know, if there are co-prime numbers, they don't have any common factor other than 1. So what will be the HCF? Yes, highest common factor will be 1 only, because there are no common factor other than 1. Okay. Next is number 4 property. Number 4 property, LCM of coprime number is equal to the product of coprime. So what happen in coprime numbers? There is no common factor between the two numbers, or no common multiple, you can say. Like in question number 5 from exercise 4.10, we can see that there are two numbers, 7 and 17. See, they are exactly what? They are coprime. Okay, they are 7, 17 are coprime numbers. Okay, because they don't have any common factor. So what will be the LCM of these two numbers? Yes, in this case you have to multiply these two numbers. So 7 into 17, we got what? 119. So if there are coprime numbers given and you need to find the LCM, just multiply the two given numbers, you will get your LCM. Okay, so this is very simple. Already we have done this part in fraction also. You have to remember these things. Why I am recalling the topics? Because you have to link the terms or topics which you have which you are learning, okay, which you are learning, you have to link that topics in from your previous class. Like in class 5, remember one thing, I told you how to take the LCM of this number. Okay, I told you, suppose this is 8 and this is 16. I told you that if one denominator is multiple of another, then you have to take the bigger one. Okay, if they don't have any common factor, like this is 8 and this is 7, then you have to multiply the two numbers. Okay, just remember it, you will get your answer. Okay, so in question number 4 is also link of that part only. Okay, this is the topic. Here we are taking the coprime numbers and we are multiplying it so that we will get the LCM. Okay, so next is property number 5. Here it is given that HCF is a factor of LCM. In other words, we can say LCM is a multiple of HCF. That means it is a relation between LCM and HCF. Just in property number 5, okay, I am giving you a task, just take two numbers and find their HCF and LCM. You will realize the given condition will be satisfied or not. That means you will get that the number in HCF is a factor of LCM. You will get like this, and next you will get that LCM is a multiple of HCF. Okay, just take two numbers and analyze. Okay, next is number 6. 2 and 3 are prime numbers. HCF of 2 and 3 is 1. HCF of 2 or more prime number is 1. So we know this. Okay, if you take two prime numbers, then the highest common factor will be 1. Okay, so these are some properties. Just learn these properties and you have to write this property. Okay, and number 5, just take an example of two numbers and find HCF and LCM and try to do the process. Okay, so if any doubt, again, if further you face any doubt in this particular exercise or in this topic, you can also ask me. Okay, so rest is your part, you have to do it. Okay, then, thank you.